Today we take a look at NC State commit Robert Dillingham. This is the Wolfpacker of On3 Sports, the best of college sports and recruiting. When little Robert was in the 5th and 6th grade, he showed a strong shooting prowess, showed confidence, a swagger, and had an early understanding of spacing and how he can use it to his advantage. Since then, he's grown a bit, up to about 6'2", around 165. He's also the number 11 player overall in the consensus and the number 3 point guard in the country. He had a nice list of schools leading up to his commitment, with the final 5 including Kansas, Kentucky, LSU, and Memphis, and it was reported at one point he was a silent commit to Kentucky before ultimately committing to NC State. He has the prototype of a high IQ, long arm, thin, lethal shooting, crafty ball handling point guard. His player comparison today is going to be former Wake Forest guard and NBA player Jeff Teague. Quick guard off the dribble, able to shake defenders, slice the defense, but then the defense can't give space because of his shooting ability from the mid-range and from three. He's a really good shooter. I love skills that should translate to the next level, and his shooting will be a tremendous asset. He's not only a good shooter, but he understands when and how defenders can have a small mental lapse while defending him, and he's able to take full advantage. He's so fast in the pick and roll game, defenders forget they cannot go under ball screens due to Dillingham being able to shoot it at a high level. He was doing this at 16 years old, and there are some college shooters who still don't recognize these subtleties within the game. Here's a good example. When he comes off this ball screen going to his left, the defender dips behind the screen. Dillingham immediately stops on a dime, recognizing the space between him and the defender, and makes the team pay. He's comfortable shooting off the dribble from both mid-range and from three. He's also capable of playing with another ball-dominant guard. When he was playing for Team USA in FIBA, he was off the ball quite a bit, providing spacing for bigs down low and opening driving lanes for teammates. He shoots the ball beside his right eye with his shooting arm in more of a 45 degree angle than the traditional 75 to 90 degree you usually see. His offhand is also near the top of the basketball, but he has a good follow through, finishing up and out with a good snap. He's special getting to the basket, using his handle to create advantages against the defense. Part of the reason is what we just talked about, his shooting. His jump shot makes defenders have to guard him close and get in his space. He has a smooth handle, not one hand dominant, likes a little running floater going either way with correct and incorrect hand finishes. When he's handling and driving, he's not the most physically imposing, so he's not able to fully bump defenders off the ball, but he's still fairly physical. When he gets to the lane, he uses crisp footwork, attacking the defense with spins and euro steps, using long steps to glide to the rim, covering ground. In AAU, you really saw him put on a show with his handle, dancing with the basketball, keeping the ball on a string, multiple combos. This drives the clicks, right? But you're not going to see this in the ACC. What you'll see is how he played in FIBA. You'll see a couple of combos, but he's pretty straightforward with his handle, fundamental and disciplined. Has a canny ability to rip through and attack with a quick first step, getting to the lane and making a play. Pretty bouncy for his body type. This is the one main difference between him and his player comparison, Jeff Teague. Teague was explosive off of 2 feet. Now, Robert's a little different. Not so much of a 2-foot jumper, but good at going off 1 foot. He isn't the type yet to consistently dunk with contact, but he's explosive to where he could take contact, hang in the air, using the length with his arms to finish around rim protectors. This length also helps him on the defensive end. He has quick hands and decent feet, solid defender and rebounder, not great, but once he puts on some more healthy weight and continues to physically mature, he'll be much tougher to go against on that end of the court. He attacks defenses with his jump shot and around the basket with his quick first step and ball handling, scoring at all three levels effectively. As a 5-star recruit with his attributes, he attracts and commands attention as soon as he walks on the basketball court. To keep Dillingham in check, teams need to guard him with all 5 defenders knowing where he is at all times. He's able to break down the defense, and then the help starts to swarm him, rotating in a panic. Where Dillingham's game goes to another level is finding the right open teammates, delivering good passes to shooters, and catchable dump-offs to bigs. He likes to get creative with feeds, and isn't afraid of testing leapers at the rim with on-the-dot alley-oop passes for finishes over the top. Overall, he's one of the top 2023 point guards in the country and should excel at NC State under Coach Keats. He's 16 years old till January of 2022, so his body still has a ways to go for development. The next part in his game I want to see the most growth is taking another step defensively and getting more aggressive on the boards. And I highly doubt he'll be in college for long, so once you get him, enjoy him while you can.